I'm one of the lucky few to have had two S15s, so this is my second one. And back in 2007, I think it was, I bought my first S15. But then in 2010, I sold it because I came back to Gibraltar, where my dad lives and where I grew up. And I always missed it, you know, and starting a new life and starting from scratch, we all go through difficulties and things, but eventually I found myself in a better situation and I bought myself an Evo 4. When I started to sort of do a little bit better, I bought myself a GD STI fork eye, but I always missed the S15 I had and I always wanted another one. So eventually I got talking to Talk GT in Devon in the UK and started looking on the auctions and things, and then I found this almost completely stock B package Silvia spec-r, and only 1100 were made out of 43,000 S15s in total. Thought a lot about what to do with the engine, because there's quite a lot of cool, it's like RB26 builds and things around, but in the end I ended up keeping the SR20. And then we started talking about how to get a bit of extra power out of it. For about £1,000 they could get an extra 20 horsepower or whatever, but one thing led to another and we ended up taking the whole engine out, fully forged internals, Tommy cams, GT28 71R turbo, Wiseco slightly oversized forged pistons. And now we've got about 400 brake. When we had the tuning done and the mapping done, the guys in the garage were saying, like, is he sure he wants to do this? Does he know what he's getting himself in for? Because the car's only about 1100 or 1200 kilos. And of course, 23 years old next year. Of course, you haven't got any of the electronics that new cars have. So once you put your foot down with the sort of variable valve timing that the SR20 has with the bigger turbo and the tune, it just keeps going and going and going, and you just always lose traction. It's kind of can be quite difficult, especially when it's wet, to hold any sort of traction down. But when you do have traction, it can be pretty brutal because it just keeps pulling back and back and back. I always wanted to get another S15 one day when I got settled, and I've had so much work done to this one that she's quite a special car, and I don't think I'll ever get rid of her.